Good day, everyone. We are from Philippine Trust Company, or famously known as the Philtrust Bank. We are here today to discuss you about our proposed marketing plan on establishing the University Savings Bank. I am Giselle Karin M. Rosete.
I am Erica May Pagandar.
I am Bea AJ Shane E. Balboa.
I am Tyre Bill V. Arbalo.
I am Mara Patricia V. Yangbas.
And to start off, let's begin with the executive summary.
Philtrust Bank, also known as the Philippine Trust Company, is a Philippine-based commercial bank which offers commercial and investment banking finance. Philtrust Bank has 61 branches across the Philippines. The company plans to build a strong market position due to competition in area of finances. University Savings Bank aims to offer its product at a competitive price to meet the demand of the new target market, which is the university students. Philtrust Bank is up to care for the security and prosperity of its customers, as the bank serves the customers with genuineness, honesty, and reliability, guarantee the best image and interest of the clients.
One of the oldest banks in the Philippines is the Philtrust Bank, or formerly known as the Philippine Trust Company. It is founded way back on October 16, 1916, and its principal activities remain in financial and commercial investment banking services.
Philtrust mission and vision. Guided and inspired by the providential wisdom that whomever much is given, much is expected, Philtrust Bank and its management adopted the concept and philosophy that first, the business of banking is forever. Second, the authority of bank is a public trust. And lastly, banks as stewards of private and public wealth are accountable not only to its clientele, the public, the regulators, but primarily to God, the source of all riches. The strategy for growth used by the Philippine Trust Company in order to establish the University Savings Bank is the market development. The University Savings Bank is a service offered by Philippine Trust Bank for the benefit of the students who want to learn to save money from their allowances and could be able to take advantage from it in the future. In order to fully develop our market, we first need to conduct surveys regarding the needs of our students or of the target market to fully establish the marketing plan we plan to offer the public. Through this, we could be able to have wider connections and it could be easier for us to access and provide the needs our target market wants. One of the factors affecting the company's decision is the demographic environment. Act No. 8791 is an act providing for the regulation of the organization and operations of banks, quasi-banks, trust entities, and for other purposes. The economic environment. The bank maintains an adequate capital base, high liquidity, and superior asset quality. Social-cultural trends. A thing that is common with millennials nowadays is that they are given the chance to handle their monthly allowances and expenses, but most of them fail to manage their savings well. Technological environment. Philtrust Bank is being fully equipped and automated with the most modern and sophisticated bank equipment. The SWOT analysis. The strengths of the Philippine Trust Company are the existing distributions and sales networks of Philippine Trust Bank, the experienced business unit scan, the monetary assistance provided for the investments and transactions done by the company, the reduced labor costs, and the high growth rate in the Philippines. For the weaknesses, a weakness for our newly planned project, which is the University Savings Bank, is having small business units. The opportunities that the Philippine Trust Company has are the development of the University Savings Bank as an opportunity to take over in the industry of banking, and the Philtrust Bank's income level is at a constant increase. Therefore, starting a new service to offer the market would be great to get a chance of increasing the income more from its common growth. The threats of the Philippine Trust Company. As other companies which are not in the leading brand, increase in labor cost is a common threat for Philtrust Bank. Increase in cost and the limited financial capacity could also hinder the processing of the University Savings Bank. The direct competitors who are also offering savings account for students are the BDO, Power Teens Club, BPI Family Jumpstart Savings, and RCBC Wise Savings Account.
Filtres Bank is committed to look after the security and well-being of its client. In establishing the University Savings Bank, here are marketing objectives. First is to increase the sales up to at least 60% of our investment. Second is to identify the benefits of both sides, which is the client and the company. Third is to improve the products or service awareness in the market. And fourth is to establish the brand in the industry. And lastly, to create a service that will patronize by its target market or by the public because of its excellent service. Marketing communications. It will be easier for us to reach out our target market using media, through billboards and televisions, through distributing flyers and pamphlets near schools and universities, and of course, establishing a good customer relationship.
The market segmentation. With the use of the four segmenting strategies, which are the demographic, psychographic, geographic, and the behavioral, Filtres Bank were able to come up with the target market, which is the students. Positioning strategy. We're not just another bank. Filtres Bank used this tagline as they proved that they are not only creating a product that will provide what their clients need, but also offer a service that have a sustainable advantage that competitors cannot match.
The service we offer is University Bank Service, checking account, savings account, and ATM savings account. The price will be depending on the consumer's allowance or budget. Since our target market is students and teachers, the place distribution would be near university belt or schools. Able to promote our service, we will be using publicity and print media like brochures and pamphlets. People, the service will not be given to the client if there's no people who will deliver it to them, the branch manager, the bank tellers, and also the employees who will assist them. Process. In opening an account in Filtres Bank, the client may go to any branch of the bank. The client may ask to any personnel to assist them and give information about opening an account. Requirements are asked to the client and should be given to the bank personnel. After completing the set requirements, a form will be given to the client and must fill the information correctly. Now, the bank personnel will process the documents of the client and the client will wait for the further confirmation. Once the confirmation is made, finally, the personnel will ask for the initial amount to start the savings account. Physical environment. The company is giving ATM cards, checkbooks, and passbook. It can be considered as tangible evidence by the company. Financial reports are also issued to the clients to monitor their accounts and banking. Implies dress code can also be physical evidence.
For us to reach our objectives in our marketing plan, we will be using our action plan. First is to generate ideas through conducting research to know what our target market needs. After knowing their needs, we will coordinate with all the universities in planning for the orientation that will be held in the schools. And then third, the installation of Filtres automated teller machines in selected universities, and then introducing the University Savings Bank in the market, and lastly, the evaluation of its marketability through feedback system.
For the year 2017, our projected sales 1,050,000,000. It is for 500,000 students and 10,000 employees. Less expense and the tax of 7%, our return of investment is 17.57%. For year 2016, this is the projected income statement of University Savings Bank. In year 2017, 500,000 students and 10,000 employees open an account. Our projected sales is 1,050,000,000 pesos. Less the cost, expense, and tax, the net income is 896,101,500 pesos. The return of investment in year 2017 is 17.57%. In year 2018, 600,000 students and 15,000 employees open an account. Our projected sales is 1,270,000,000 pesos. Less the cost, expense, and tax, Our net income is 1,108,653,000. Our return on investment is 18.3%. Since Filters Bank wants to expand its range of consumers and services, University Savings Banks is service where the bank allows university students to open an account. If University Savings Bank fails, Filters Bank will conduct more research about the bank's target market to understand their way of income or allowance.
And that is all about our marketing plan. Again, we are from
Filters Bank.